Hi everyone, Stock Moe here. Today's video is for entertainment purposes only, and we're gonna get into the action that happened today. It was one of the worst days for the NASDAQ in 2 months, but it does ask the question, is there some opportunities out there to take advantage of? I'm gonna go over a little bit of what I bought today, as well as where I see some of these stocks going. I'm gonna share my YouTube portfolio and my leverage portfolio today as well. So stick around. I think you're gonna like what I got for you. For those new to the channel, I am Stock Moe. I'm an old financial advisor and educator, and now I do this YouTube thing. All I ever ask, hit that subscribe button, and then, of course, hit the little bell for the notifications. You hit all, and every time I put a video out, which is usually twice a day, you're gonna get a little notification and come over and see how I'm doing and any stocks we may have found. I do have a link down below to Webull. Right now is a great time to get 2 free stocks. All you gotta do is put 100 bucks in there, 2 free stocks. They have Dogecoin, they have Ethereum, they have Bitcoin, and you never know. You're gonna get that shot at 1850 in free stocks, possibly. I get 1 free share because I'm an affiliate, but guaranteed your 2 free stocks. I do have a link over there to my Patreon as well. We have thousands of members and, of course, a private Discord. You can watch the portfolios. You can get notifications when I'm buying and selling and all that good stuff moving forward. So we're going to get into talking about what happened today. I'm going to show you the YouTube portfolio, my leverage portfolio, and a couple of the things I have done. A lot of people asking me today if this is the beginning of the stock market crash, a new correction, because we are down 5% from the highs that we just experienced in the NASDAQ. And that's a tough question to answer because right now we see a lot of things going on. You got the Dow hardly even moving today, but you got the Russell, you got the NASDAQ getting hammered. But so we're going to go over some of the stocks that are in these and we're going to see where we can go from here. The first things first, though, we can take a look at the market. Dow Jones down 0.1%, hardly even moving. And of course, I looked at the portfolio. A lot of those infrastructure plays that I added in to my portfolio over the last few weeks actually were green. It was the growth stocks, the continuation of the EVs getting hammered, the clean energy getting hammered, the gambling stocks getting hammered. A lot of those have an outflow of money and it is just taking a toll on them. As you can see right here, 7% down for NIO, Tesla 6.44 and 6.36. I've been watching NIO closely because I wanted, you know, my NIO stock price prediction continues to stay the same. I expect it to be in the 60s by the end of the year. We will see. I know a lot of the analysts see the same thing. I'm going to go over some of that with you and we're going to talk about this. But DraftKings ones I haven't talked about in a while. It is getting down to that level that I'm actually thinking about adding more on once it got, you know, hits them 40s. I'm going to show you some charts and show you what I'm looking at. They are going to be the dominant player in the gambling industry once we get through the pandemic and all sports are rolling 100% again. I think their revenue is going to go through the roof, but we're going to take a look at it. They're not spared from this entire correction that we're seeing, and we're going to watch into this. Now, I will show you this, though. Take a look at the YouTube portfolio. I haven't shared this in a while. I like to do it about once a week. We will see that it is down $18,000 since we started this. Our goal was to be up about $250,000 altogether. That's what we want this to be valued at. By the end of this year, we will find out. I am dollar cost averaging, and you can tell that the correction continues because no matter what we're adding in here, with the exception of Tesla, it is dropping. And even Tesla is only up to 9% now since we bought it. And you can see the beginning stocks that we bought are getting hammered, and they are a wide variety of stocks. It just continues to be downward pressure. Now, the good news is that I do have the triple leverage one that I actively manage, and I've been moving my stocks around here. The only one that's really hurt me right now is Soxel. This is a triple leverage semiconductor stock, and that is down about 16%. I lost about $3,300 on that, but you can see some of the ones I have in here, and Nail all the way up. That's up 61% now. The banking triple leverage is now up over 100%. This is the one, for those that don't know, I put $100,000 in, and I'm going to let that go. I'm going to actively manage it through the end of the year, and then I'm going to be done with it. And the same thing with the YouTube portfolio. That is a one-year dollar cost average into it, and the other one is a triple leverage. How can we do with it actively managing it? So far, we're doing really good. 37.89% up, $39,000. And of course, this one is not that good, down 23% or down 18,000. So there's give and take here, and you got to watch it. But looking at this, you can see what stocks are really doing well. I have doubled up a little bit extra in UDow. That moved up to 20%. I moved some of that out of the tech into here. And you're seeing the moves that you can make, and you can look at the market and consistently see certain stocks doing well. And the ones that are under pressure are the, like I said, the high growth stocks. I think we all know I got a lot of those in the portfolio. Let's go ahead and take a look at NIO first, and we'll see what's going on. You can see that it ended up down 7%, down another 1.31% in the after hours. I do like NIO for the long term. I've said this before. I expect it to rally back. It's going to be one of the leaders in this industry. They just got done helping the Chinese government write new regulations to start on November 1st for battery swap stations. Not only are there new regulations, but NIO sat down at the table and helped write them. So I'm feeling really good about their future prospects, and we know that they are looking at expansion around the world. So I get it. There's a big sell-off. You can see down here all the stocks are getting hammered. No one was spared. But if you look at outside of the high growth, you're going to see some of the infrastructure plays. Some of the bank stocks were doing okay. And if you look at the Dow, it's only down 0.1. I've been saying this. A lot of the money has been rolling into the Dow. Those stocks might not be crazy looking where it's all, hey, it's going to go up 100, 200% in a year, but they're doing well. They're holding their own. And compared to a lot of these growth stocks, they're the ones that give me a little bit of diversity and holding the losses down a little bit. I am getting hit just like everyone else today. A lot of my stocks are in the high growth, as well as I showed you the triple leverage and some other things out there, but the YouTube portfolio getting hammered, but the triple leverage did okay. So I'm looking at these. I'm seeing where we're going. I'm going to be adding on some more NIO most likely this week. I'm going to take a look and see how the market reacts over the next few days. I like to buy at these prices. I don't want to wait until it gets back up to 38 to 40 range. I want to make sure I'm dollar cost averaging into these. But I did say I was going to dollar cost average into my newest play, which is, and we can take a look at the YouTube portfolio, Ethereum. Down here, you'll see I added that in today. And you can see that I ended up buying it right before the big crash of the Ethereum we saw today. I got in at 41.35 within a half hour. An hour later, we saw the big dump from all the cryptos out there just tanked. And that was one of them. I did end up buying a little bit more crypto for my portfolios over at the Patreon. After that big correction, I got in a little over 38. And we can see it's getting up there to 38.79 right now. So I'm going to continue to buy Ethereum. I'm not going to be turning bearish on this anytime soon. Anytime I see the dips like that, I want to buy. But if there are no dips, it just kind of trades sideways. I'll be buying every Monday. You'll be hearing about the newest additions I'll be doing. But if I see dips out there, 5, 10% dips, I'll most likely be adding a little bit on to that portfolio. If you'd like to see when I'm doing that, like I said, I'll be sharing that over at the Patreon and the Discord. So as we move into Tesla, you can see that they were not spared either. They're down in the after hours, down 6.4. Over the last 6 months, it's up 50%, but over the last month, down 10%. NIO down over the last month, only 7%. So I do think that NIO, if you look at it that way, yeah, we're going through this correction, but it, you know, a lot of us saw it at 42 all the way down to 33.88 now. And that's painful to see, but I am very bullish on this long term. I think there are triple digit gains and triple digit increases, I should say, on the revenue and all that good stuff will continue on as they get through the chip shortage, the pandemics. All this has to just kind of go away. And then I think you're going to see a good amount of growth from this company. So I'm going to stay bullish on it. Here's one, though, I got asked about. I do like this one. Over the last year, it's up 85%. Over the last 6 months, up 8%. But over the last month, it's down 21.87%. So if we actually look at the high of where it was and where it is now, it's down 37%. This is DraftKings. And I do think that the DraftKings price prediction that I would throw out there, I did thought it would get up there by the end of this year. I'm talking January. I thought it would see up there close to 80. We got up there close to it, set in the 70s. Never got up there, but now we're going through a major correction for DraftKings. Anything over 10% is big time. And this got down over 20, which gets that bear market for this. And we're seeing that action right now. And we are getting very close to what we were back in, we're all the way back into basically November, when it was the last time we can get down at this price. And we did see it a little bit here in January, but then it rebounded up. So we'll see how it does. I don't think it'll hit down into the 30s. I think right now would be a decent time to start adding a little bit of this on if you believe that the gambling industry and the sports industry, all that good stuff, is going to recover well. And you believe that DraftKings is going to be your winner in this, the leader out of them, which I believe it's going to be, this is a good opportunity. We can take a look at tip ranks, of course, and see what they think. All the analysts here, Morgan Stanley, Merrill Lynch, Deutsche Bank, and you can see they have NIO at $62.50 now averaged in. That is an upside potential of 82% over the next 12 months. So I'm not alone in thinking that NIO is going to have a good run, but we need to get through these rough days. And I do think we're getting close to the end. I'm hoping this is the final shaking, if you will, to where you go through the corrections. It usually gets to that point of everybody just kind of gives up. And then you see the beginning of the next bull run. And of course, here's Tesla. Now look at this, 25.24% upside potential. And that's based on this. And yesterday, Dan Ives came out and gave it a $1,000 price target. And that's over the next 12 months. DraftKings, look at this, 56.73% upside potential. Look at all these people that came out today saying that they expect this to be higher, or some of them at 54, 60, 63, 70, 75, 73. Averaged out, though, all of them expected it to be higher that I can see on the screen here. And that's good. That's good news. So if you're wondering about the DraftKings and you're saying, hey, how are the analysts? What do you think about it? I think it's at a really good price right now. So I'm kind of surprised. I'm actually looking to adding some of this on tomorrow. I'm not sure I'm going to be taking a look at it, look into some of the numbers and seeing where we're going to go. I don't think the downside is going to be much more than maybe 10 to 15% from here. And then that's where I think you're going to see some major resistance, some buying. And so for me, I think it's limited in how low it would go if I added on additional capital into this. So that's what I got for you. It's been a crazy day out there, a lot of red out there. You got the cryptos getting hammered, the growth stocks getting hammered. The only thing that was looking good were them value plays, the infrastructure plays, and some of the banking stocks were looking pretty decent. And so you got to be careful out there. But I am holding. I didn't sell anything, and I'm looking forward to I actually added on some more crypto. I'm going to be adding on some more stocks throughout this week to add into some of these positions that I think are getting way too low. I love DraftKings for the long run, and you know how I feel about Tesla and NIO. So I'm going to be looking. I did give some good videos this morning on some dividend stocks, some value plays. If you're interested in seeing that, I'll put a link in the description down below as well. I appreciate you coming out. Get those two free stocks from Webull. You only have to put $100 in there. You might get $1,850 in free stocks, and you can buy the crypto over there, the Dogecoin, the Ethereum, and the Bitcoin. And if you want to come over and check out my picks and all my stocks I got going on, you can check out that link down in the description as well, over to the Patreon. And of course, I have the tip ranks link down below if you like to see these charts and look into insider and hedge funds and who's buying what. I appreciate you stopping by. Let's get out there and make some money.